Hello, YouTube. Welcome to day 14 of Vlogmas.
Hey guys, welcome to day 13 of Vlogmas. Today we're taking a look at the back 10 of Camp Sekani disc golf course. Shout out to Huntington Coates, Caddy Daddy. He does great lessons. Check him out. He's got some sweet merch too. So today we're going to be taking a look at that back 10. I believe I'm shooting one or two down on the front 10 in the first video. This is coming back at a different day and trying to keep that going. So my goal at this course is 6 down overall. So I think we got a little bit of work left to do, but we'll see what we can do. All right, welcome to the back 10 at Sekani. We played the front 10 earlier about a week ago. And so now I'm coming back to play the back 10. So we're starting it off at hole 11. This is 284 feet. This is a straight to hyzer shot. You've got a bunch of trees in the way. Always a bunch of trees in the way. So I'm gonna throw my volt. It is uphill, so I'm reaching for the fairway driver quite a bit uphill, but try and pop it down the right gap and let this overstable fairway finish towards the basket. First real throw of the day. Let's see what we got. A little inside. Yeah, a little inside, but with one to beat, that would have been all the way to the pin. Nothing like a tester to save par, but this is only, my guess is 6 paces, so this should be pretty automatic. Oh yeah, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and a half. Automatic. All right, hole 12 is 305 feet uphill to the right. This one is one of the most uphill shots on the track. You can get there with the power sidearm or with how far it is. I'm gonna try the turnover. And as I say that, we are getting a little bit of snow. So we got 9 more holes to go and hopefully it doesn't start really snowing by the time we're done. Oh boy. Well, that might be interesting. I threw that really hard. Okay, so I got aggressive off the tee, which means I've got a wall of trees. I never like taking, so my first thought is turnover putter, and that's definitely there, but I always like to look at least one other option before I throw my shot. So there is a thumber play. I need to work on my thumber. So maybe I'll throw it second. Well, let's do the play I'm most confident in, which is a turnover putter. And we got probably 100 feet still, uphill, so a little bit of power. Yeah, we got through. So a little bit of a tester. Let's try the thumber. I'm gonna go pioneer for that. Okay. Now pan back to the right. Okay. That's sliding back down the hill. That'll take some work, but I think that's a good play I need to work on. Here we are with another tester, and I'm breathing hard because my asthma doesn't like the cold dry. Oh yeah, no problem. And we got a broken chain on this guy. All right, hole 13, 234 feet. This is pillars. This is an iconic one because you have this gap on the right side, but you have the two pillar trees that you can throw between, and if you do, you're getting all the way to the basket. However, I'm gonna go high left because it's more open that way. So this shot is totally fun to try and get your straight shot down, but high left it is. All right, hit the gap. Coming in. Oh yeah, that's bullseye. Let's go, great shot. That one you have to kind of risk. You have to risk the roll away when you're coming in on a steep angle like that. But if you do get a rollaway, it should still be an easy par, whereas I never want to get caught up in this early stuff because that can make it a very hard par. I'm just coming off editing my downriver video, and in my downriver video I have two missed putts from exactly that distance, if not closer. So, appreciate these baskets for catching solid stuff here. You still have to be careful of the scoops, but at least I know if I'm hitting the pole, it should stay in unless I just put it way too soft. All right, here we are at hole 14. It's 367 feet. This one is in the to the right position. So it's a forehand, or a big spike hyzer, or thumber, or a backhand turnover. But in any case, it's kind of a cool top of the world shot. You're throwing off of a cliff. There isn't a defined fairway, and all of the gaps have a ton of branches in it, so this is kind of a poke and hope hole. I think if this hole had a defined fairway, where you took like one of these trees out and you opened it up and you limbed up all the branches, this would become a super cool hole that you would throw your entire bag. But as soon as you have a hole like this, which is so cool, but it becomes a poke and hope, I think you lose a lot of value there. But we'll see if I can get through. I'm throwing my rafter, something stable through the left side, and having it finish towards the basket. We hit the gap, and now we just wait and see. Yeah, we got one of the last trees on the way. Should be an easy par. This is actually a tricky green to lay up to, so we'll see if I can execute. I don't want to crash this either left or right because it's kind of on a little bit of a knoll, so I'm trying to land right in front of the basket, get a little ground strip under it, and call it good. So a little touchy side. Okay, maybe a little inside. A little inside, but I don't think we got too much of a roll away, so should be looking like an easy par. All right, hole 15 is a 262-foot shot. You have kind of a gauntlet you have to throw through right off the bat, just a few gaps here. And in this right position, you want your disc to finish to the right. There's a whole bunch of trees in the way, so you can try and get all the way to the basket by getting lucky through the trees on the right. Or if you just punch it straight, you can try and get kind of a backdoor look up top. This one has, the green on this one is only about 5 feet in each direction, and it's on top of a rock. So it's almost impossible to park it, and in general, the closer you are to the basket, the more likely you're gonna not get a birdie. So this is one you're trying to land on the edge of the circle and then figure out if you're going to run the putt or if you're gonna try and lay up, because it's a lot easier to land on a 5 foot diameter surface when you're 30 feet away than 262 feet away. I'm going flip up forehand with the Onyx. Guardian trees. I think if we don't catch the tree, we're scooting up to a solid circle one putt. Now we're probably edge of circle one or circle two, and I'm really gonna have to evaluate if I'm gonna run this or not. And this is one, even when you're sitting here at 10 feet, you're like, please don't air ball. Please don't hit the Cajun roll. Please don't. And so you just have to say, pull. Me, disc, pole, that's all we got going on. Hole 16, 293 feet. This is a straight shot. You have a tunnel the entire way from the tee pad all the way to the basket. The basket is on a bridge and it's elevated probably 8 feet from the base of it. And it's a little bit uphill up this gully. So you can be sitting at like 25, 30 feet and have a really tricky putt. But I'm throwing Undertaker. I'm gonna hit it hard on the left side of the fairway and let it drift right the entire way. See if we can execute. It's drifting. Oh, we caught one of the last blockers.
And that might be that really tricky 35-40 foot putt I was just talking about, but we'll see what we got.
Get in! Woo!
All right, hole 17. This is 535 feet in the short position. This is extremely downhill. It is a par four, even though you can definitely get there in one. What makes it a par four, there's no true line all the way to the basket. You can flex a sidearm through the right gap, follow that, and then get lucky at the end. And then you will have, I guess, a pure line all the way to the basket. But you have these trees directly in front of you with branches on either side, which means you have to throw off the right side of the fair or the right side of the tee pad towards the right gap, or the left side of the tee pad towards the right gap, and just don't try and throw into the trees directly ahead of you and hope to get lucky through all these branches. My play to get a three on this hole is to take a hex or a stable mid of some sort, maybe a little bit more stable than a hex, throw it out the right gap, try and land in the fairway, and then have an easy approach. But that's not as fun, so we're gonna try the sidearm flex shot and see if we can get all the way there for an eagle.
Hop top, tie-dye destroyer, don't fail me now. Hey, we hit first available. All right, this is the risk on that hole, on this hole. You get aggressive and you get punished for throwing at the thing directly in front of the tee pad. All right, get going. Get going, come back. That got caught by the last blocker rocks, but I think we're gonna have a potential birdie save, but easy par for sure. Edge of circle two for a birdie save. Oh, hit the pole. Okay, that's a bit of a comebacker. Did it. I've been able to save a bunch of bogeys today, or save a bunch of pars. Not this time. Hole 18, this used to be the finishing hole before they added two more, is 333 feet off the top of a hill. This one has a little bit cleaner lines than some of the other top of the hill shots. So you can actually go a backhand all the way to the basket, or there's a little bit of room on the left as a bailout area if you want to do a flex sidearm. You have OB long and OB left. So if you're landing anywhere past the basket, you're likely to skip away, which is why I've opted for an overstable disc like the zone. So I'm gonna go sidearm and see if we can't match the line. Hit the gap, but it's a little bit too overstable. Easy par from there. For me, it's always been a tricky birdie. This basket has been my nemesis hole. I've had some great rounds where I've taken a bogey on this hole. I've missed easy putts, I've missed comebackers. So I'm just gonna put this in for a two. Oh, okay, I left it short. I wanted to give that enough power, but that's okay. All right, basket, don't do me dirty now. All right, hole 19, this is 293 feet. This is the first of the new holes. This one is way up there and on top of a rock, which makes it a super tough green. You can be 5-10 feet away from the basket and rolling away to 40. So the safe side of this basket is on the left side. So I'm gonna throw a big hyzer, try and get over all the rocks and then just crash the left side and have a 25 foot death putt, because I think that's one of the better results you can get on this hole. Oh, that's nasty. That's the first time I've left that inside. Well, with this being a new hole, this is a new place for me to land on the fairway. There is absolutely no line to the basket, so we're gonna have to make something up. I might go spike sidearm, because that looks beef. I'm gonna disc up, because we're throwing a standstill sidearm, and I don't want to be short on this one. I mean, with how tight these gaps are, I don't feel bad about that. All right, two throws, and we're 200 feet from the tee pad in the middle of the fairway again. So, stand still sidearm again. Oh no. Yeah, I hadn't quite completely decided where I was trying to land. Land on the left side and have a death putt, which isn't something that you want. Land on the right side and not be able to land on the right side. So I haven't decided where I actually am trying to land on this hole. And I think you could see that in that approach shot where I just wasn't committed because I still don't know where I would want to land on this hole. All right, here I am in the middle of a thorny bush with feels like at least 60 feet of power straight uphill. No real good place to lay up either. All right, let's give this a run and see what happens. Ugh, you can see how tight this green is because I'm 6 feet from the basket and have something tricky. This is where I wish I had a better turbo, but I don't. So let's just try and punch it in there. I mean, my head's at least a couple feet below the basket, so this is very uphill. All right, get off this hole and let's try the turbo. No problem. All right, here we are at hole 20. This is gonna be our finishing hole. It is a 600 foot par four, top of the world shot. You have trees directly off the middle of your tee pad. So once again, you can't actually use your center of your tee pad. You have to kind of pretend like your tee pad is pointing this way because that's the fairway, or pointing this way if you're going down the skinny gap. I found that my best play here is going flex sidearm. And we got some people down there, so they might be having me play through. Let's see. You guys good if I play through? Get off it. Flex back. Okay. We got all the way down there. That's an easy par, or birdie. This one's a little bit trickier of an approach with these two blockers in the way, but not too bad. Of course, if you do that, it's not very good at all. All right, we got this left to save the birdie and finish on a birdie. I keep trying to say par, because it really feels like a par getting a three on this hole. But with this being on a stump, it's actually super easy to blow past this and get out to about 35. Yeah, that's the one I'm talking about. Edge a circle putt and we can get out of here. All right.
Thanks for watching. That was a super fun round. Whew. Sekani is one of the more challenging courses in that it rewards people who play conservatively, and it teaches people that in order to score well on some courses like Sekani, you have to play conservatively, and that going for highlight shots at certain courses, such as this one, can be punishing. So you have to learn discipline depending on what course you're playing. So no highlights at this course, or very few, but that is the trade-off. So thanks for watching, guys. If you like my content, hit that like button. If you want to see more of my content, hit the subscribe button. And if you want to get notified when my new videos are about to come out, hit the notification bell. All right, we'll see you tomorrow as part of day 15 of Vlogmas. We are taking a look at the final round of the Spokane Disc Golf Club League. So that league had a scoring system throughout the year. And the top point getters in both the pro and am division played the final round. I was able to squeeze or sneak in as the fourth player in the pro division with enough points to be in the final. And we're playing a one round winner takes all tournament, I guess, with one card for all of the glory and a little bit of change too. All right, check that out tomorrow. And we'll see you then.